Hey guys, welcome back. This week we're going to cover the chassis prep of putting the Subaru into the VW and everything that goes into that as far as the preparation before we put the engine in. We're going to mount or figure out the area for the computer underneath the cabinet. We're going to just kind of eliminate any unnecessary items in the engine bay, and then we're going to replace the transmission input seal and, you know, just stuff like that. So follow along as we get started on that.
Here's approximately where the computer is going to rest in this kind of unusable little cubby right underneath the Westy cabinet. So we're going to be drilling a hole into the body there, into the flat sheet metal. And here's our grommet that we're going to use. Came off of the Subaru wiring harness, in which this is a stripped down version right here. And I like to do this kind of stuff before the engine's in, just because it's, you know, if you need to get into the engine bay, it makes it a little easier. So I'm going to get working on that. And then I'm going to look into identifying our wires in the black box, what we need to tie into. I'm going to replace the throwout bearing and input shaft seal on the transmission. I'm going to be getting rid of this death trap, this little plastic piece, going to be undoing that, and then kind of playing around with the coolant lines and whatnot, getting them ready. And we also have power steering, and these connections are just totally shot. I mean, I can't even get these apart. Lots of rust up in that region of the country, so I'm gonna look into getting these completely replaced up to the front. Anyway, that'll give me a little bit of work here. It's all fun and good. We're gonna get started drilling that hole right now though. All right, the hole is drilled in the side wall here, and it's pretty easy access from the cubby down here. And I drilled a bigger hole to clear out the cabinetry, and then drilled a smaller, this is 2-inch hole saw to fit the grommet. So this grommet actually squishes a little bit to make it round, and it fits perfectly in that hole. So what I've also done is started to identify the wires that we need. This is going to be where I put a little fuse for the ignition on, things like that. And I now have a new input seal on the transmission. So next up, I'm going to be reworking the fuel lines. This one's clamped off. This is a supply line. So here's how I like to remove seals. I thought I'd mention this real quick. I'm going to do the same with the rear main on the Subaru engine. Basically, just take a wood screw and kind of gently tap it into the meat of the seal, and then use a screwdriver and just kind of bore into it just a touch, just so it has enough bite so that when you pull on this, when you pull on it, you can use the claw side of a hammer. It kind of pulls it out, and no harm done, and it's super easy and fast and great in my opinion. Seal pullers just stink. Anyway, thought that might help. So the new throwout bearing is on, and the transmission housing is cleaned up pretty well. So the next step is to actually get the engine prepped. And we're pretty much done with the chassis prep. There's always going to be little stuff that you have to tweak, but for now, we're good. Let's go ahead and get the Subaru engine prepped, and then we'll look at getting it installed.